Lens Studio now features remote assets, a new way to decrease the initial download size of your lens. Remote assets also allows you to significantly increase the overall number of assets usable in a single lens. We can now create a library of reusable and shareable assets for our organization's lens catalog, including up to 500 megabytes of models, sounds, images, and prefabs. Since remote assets are loaded by script calls after our lens is downloaded, they don't count towards the 8 megabyte size limit. Let's learn how to make remote assets a key utility in our Lens Studio toolkit. The first step in working with remote assets is to set up an organization associated with our Snap account. Organizations often correspond to your company or team, and you may already have one if you've been creating and publishing lenses. If you do, you can skip the next step. Open Remote Assets in Lens Studio, and we'll first see a blue button labeled Create Organization in the Remote Assets window. Pressing Create Organization will take us to an external web browser where we can log in with our Snap ID. Then, on the next page, we can assign an organization name, as well as a folder to store our remote assets. Once these steps are complete, we'll be able to upload remote assets for use in our lenses. Now that we can upload assets, let's add the ability to preview them in our scene. First, add the Preview Remote Asset helper script from the asset library. This is a simple helper prefab with a script which will display an associated remote asset. Drag the Preview Remote Asset prefab to the Objects panel. We'll be building our lens for the rear camera, so let's change to the rear camera in the Preview panel. Now we need some assets to test, so let's import the Toy Box models from the Asset library. With these imported, let's drag the Toy Box model prefab into the Objects panel. The toys look a bit big, so let's click the Link button to uniformly scale them in the Properties panel down to 0.5. Select each toy and set their position to 0, 0, 0, and adjust their rotation so they all face the same direction. With our models ready, drag each of the items into the Resource panel to create prefabs for each. Open the Remote Assets panel and multi-select the new toy prefabs to add them to our folder. Once the uploads are complete, we can select the Preview Remote Asset object and drag our remote asset references from the Resources panel to the Reference Asset field to see our toys in the Preview panel. It's pretty fun to just swap them out and look at the cute models. Let's dive a little deeper into some uses of remote assets. We'll create a gift box that pops out a new remote asset every time a Snapchatter taps the screen. From the Asset library, import the Gift Box Animated Asset. Then drag the prefab to the Objects panel. The gift box will open automatically, and it contains an envelope that pops out, as well as a confetti particle effect. Since we don't need the envelope or the confetti, we'll just delete those. Finally, we'll move the object down negative 8 units on the y-axis. Next, we'll move the Toy Box models prefab into the gift box hierarchy and tweak their transform so they look nice popping out of the box. The scene with no remote assets currently uses 1.69 megabytes. Not bad, but with remote assets, we can do much better. Next, we'll replace the Toy Box prefabs with remote asset prefabs. Select the objects under the Toy Box and delete them. Then we'll open the Asset library and find the Remote Asset Cycler asset and import it. Next, we'll add the Remote Asset Cycler prefab to the Objects panel. We'll add the four remote assets to the cycler. Change the onDownloaded action to Instantiate Prefab, then set the prefab parent property to the Toy Box models object in the Giftbox hierarchy. With remote assets replacing our models, our lens is now only 0.38 megabytes on initial load, with 1.4 megabytes of remote assets loading in later. A pretty significant improvement to our initial download size. By default, the remote asset cycler is set up with a behavior script to randomly load models when you tap the screen. We will change this behavior to load the next model and restart the animation mixer. First, let's edit the current behavior attached to the remote asset cycler. There is already a touch event set to tap, which makes an API call on the remote asset cycler, which currently triggers the getRandom function. We want to have it cycle through our list of objects, so let's change this to use the getNext function instead. Next, we'll add a second behavior script to the same object. Change the response type to AnimateMesh. Select the animation mixer from the gift box as a target. To finish setting this up, we'll select the animation mixer for the gift box and disable autoplay. Back in the behavior script, change the layer name to OpenGift and change the action to play so that it will reset the animation every time we tap the screen. You can now cycle through the remote assets with each tap. Nice. Adding a shadow mat and tweaking our Giftbox shadow settings helps ground our scene. Even with all of this extra polish, Remote Assets keeps our initial lens download at a slender 0.43 megabytes and an extra 1.5 megabytes downloading after we are up and running. That's a nice snappy load for our Snapchatters and reasonable lift once they are using the lens. This means a better experience when getting started with the lens, as well as a richer experience when using it after download. Thanks for watching.